مولاي قد نمت عيون وتيقظت أيضا عيون، نمت عيون الخائنين.
In recent days, the veil has come under scrutiny from different quarters. Veiled women may be seen as oppressed, but this is a notion that needs to be expelled from the global community. Women such as Aisha have made great strides in expelling this negative notion that has indeed affected so many chaste women around the globe. Aisha is an educated woman who also dons the veil. She was homeschooled in her hometown of White River and matriculated with 5 distinctions, alhamdulillah. At a tender age of 16, she completed the memorization of the Holy Quran Kareem under the guidance and tutelage of her mother, and thereafter went on to complete a BSc degree in computer science from the University of South Africa through correspondence. All these achievements have been accomplished through the confines of her home. Alongside her husband Qari Ziyad Patel, Aisha has traversed disaster zones around the globe, delivering humanitarian aid to victims of earthquakes, floods, volcanoes, and even dangerous conflicts. Aisha is a perfect example of the fact that donning the veil is no indication of incapability or failure.
The hijab is no constriction for serving humanity whatsoever. With an array of disasters unfolding worldwide, the Al Imdad Foundation always mobilizes its relief teams into action. As part of its procedures and protocols, the needs of women and children are always assessed in every disaster situation. Having complied with various formalities ranging from personal preparation to liaising with various authorities, the team, which includes myself and my husband Qari Ziyad Patel, need to work quickly and efficiently. The team always informs the United Nations of its arrival in any disaster zone and begins its checklist of important activities. As the Al Imdad Foundation is registered with the United Nations, it provides them with both information and any assistance that they might require. Another important task that forms part of its checklist is erecting the South African flag. We are always cognizant of the fact that we are representing South Africa and all South Africans. As a veiled woman, I say that I am also here to represent all those that have donned the hijab. We too can make a difference in the lives of many affected victims. The Al Imdad Foundation's prime focus is on immediate disaster relief, and this entails ensuring that meals and shelter are provided as soon as possible to those within the camps. In this instance, the team found themselves at a border point between Tunisia and Libya called Ras Ajdir. The Shusha refugee relief camp was set up about 3 kilometers from the border and was host to refugees from countries such as Bangladesh, Somalia, Eritrea, Palestine, Chad, Nigeria, Senegal, and Ivory Coast. The women are remarkably strong. They know that they got to be strong for their families. However, there were basic necessities that they needed that we, the Al Imdad Foundation, tried to provide in the form of hygiene packs. It was very important for me as a woman to be there, as I was able to gain access to the many of the women who were also in hijab. Haiti was one of the most difficult trips that we have ever undertaken. We reached Haiti very soon after the earthquake and the conditions were really tough. There were bodies strewn everywhere, no supplies, and a huge language barrier. We ended up staying there for 8 weeks, during which time my husband Ziad got extremely ill and was almost in a coma. It was extremely scary to be faced with such an uncontrollable situation, but shukr to Allah, we made it through. Many people ask me what makes me keep going back. And the simple answer I always give them is that in my small way, I feel that I'm doing something for the Ummah. And I, as a Muslim sister, as a Muslim human being, have an obligation to let the world know that veiled women are also quite capable in a world that has really not given them a chance. In conclusion, I urge you, the women of this great Ummah, to take that first step in going out there and making a difference. Within your homes, your immediate families, then your communities, and thereafter to all those suffering in different parts of the world. One's efforts and initiatives may differ, but there is a common goal that we all are aiming towards. That is striving to serve humanity. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us as women to naturally be inclined to this noble work of serving humanity. As the only qualification for this job, in the words and advice of our national coordinator and founder, Yaqub Wahid, has stated, is to have a humanitarian heart.
وهي ترسخ في